planning on doing a second part of the art hold video this weekend, but here we are with the sketchbook time video instead. So I'm just gonna draw in the sketchbook and talk a little bit over it. The sketchbook itself is a Strathmore watercolor journal. It's a very small sketchbook, it has about 20 pages. I'm almost done with it, there will be a tour soon. This particular page is a different paper though. It's a Canal water paper pad that I used for this. Some time back I used a page from this sketchbook for like a small piece that I have given away. At the time I didn't have any loose papers or even paper blocks around, so I just did a bit of an amputation in the sketchbook and took the page out. So this left me with this unsightly stump, and I have decided to Frankenstein this a bit and just glued the Canal paper to the stump. It's better than it was before. This is why the paper looks wider on this side. On the other side, I just test swatched my current reds and pinks.
Thank you.
So anyways, back to the drawing. First, I'm sketching with the Prismacolor color erase pencil. The pink becomes very invisible under watercolor. Yes, I suppose I should mention I am sketching a chicken. The idea of a chicken in Converse shoes came to mind and it just wouldn't leave, so I had to be sketched. I'm not making this sketch very detailed. It's more of a general shape of a bird and the feather flow direction, just to give me a guide. The shoes I did want to sketch out, they did take me a bit to work out. This is kind of out of my comfort zone for the shoes. So you see me struggling a bit and the pencil lines are just getting darker and darker. In the end, I did get them to where I was kind of happy. The next step was to ink the shoes. I only inked the shoes because I was trying to preserve the look and the detail in them, and I didn't think I could do it without inking. The chicken I did not ink. Just went straight with the watercolor for the bird. Thank you. the watercolors that I used for this one were Schminke, Spinal Brown, Daniel Smith, Quinacridone Burnt Orange, and Daniel Smith Lamp Black. I like Lamp Black a lot. Lamp Black does this very nice fuzzy thing and flows out into other wet spots. So like it gets a really nice diffused look, feathery look. I try to leave white spaces, but as always, I have gone a little bit too much with the color. I'm still trying to learn that part. It's a little hard to know when, where to stop, what to leave white. The brushes I'm using here are Simply Simon Surround number 3. I did get that one from Jackson's. It was a little bit on the cheaper side, but it's a pretty decent brush. And the larger one is the number 8 from Heinz Jordan. That one I picked up at a local art store. It was a good medium priced brush. It has kind of an okay tip. I am getting to the point where I want to invest into a better brush though. Something with a more full body, but yet that tiny tip. I'm not sure which one to get. I will leave the supplies that I have used in the description below.
Thank you.
I did have a bit of a technical issue and the camera stopped recording the part where I did color to the shoes. And the color that I used was Schminke Matter Lake Deep. And then I went in with some pencils just to deepen some contrast. The pencils I'm using are Derwent and Current Ash Mix. Getting good contrast with just watercolor alone is also something I'm trying to improve on. It is a bit of a struggle right now, but I think it's slowly getting better. I'm also using some bleedproof white on the laces and just to get some white back into the chicken. And then I went back to the pencils and fussed around with the contrast some more. In the end, I think I have gone a bit too far and the chicken ended up being a little too busy looking. Although that's how some chickens are in real life. It's a little bit too much to look at. I still like it a lot though. I do like the idea. I might actually redo it at some point in time later just to see if my skill has improved. But this was a fun one to do.